All right, here we go. I got a pretty good response from the last one of these that I did. So I'm gonna do another unboxing video of Catacombs, which I just received. I got through Boards and Bits, great place. Anyway, I didn't take the shrink wrap off because I was just gonna show on the very front of the game. It is a thank you for purchasing the game, but also a explanation of some errata that they've noticed, which is cool that they noticed it, and you know, it's included with the game, so that's pretty cool. Anyway, I'll take that off, put it aside. The box, I don't know, I mean, it is what it is. It's kind of plain looking, but you know, you definitely can tell what the name of the game is. Obviously, that's a pretty dumb comment, but anyway, on the back, some more information, but you probably already know exactly what the game is all about. So, let me crack this open. I usually try to take the shrink wrap off. I found that it's a little tough to hold a camera and remove shrink wrap at the same time. So, I'm going to get this off here. I apologize. There you go, shrink wrap is off. Let's take the game box off now. Of course, the first time you open a box is always a little bit difficult. But there we go, and what have we got inside? Alright, first thing we have, these little discs that you're going to be flicking around in the game. I don't know, just wooden, very cool, very sturdy, very thick, very cool. A little silica gel packet in there, that's kind of nice, so no mold. Looks like these are the different character sheets. They don't look very thick, but they look thick enough. That's good. Deck of cards, standard sized. Deck cards, these little tiny cards that I'm not a fan of at all. I have big, giant, clumsy hands, and I always feel like I'm going to crush these when I hold on to them. But I know lots of people have no problem with them. Maybe it's just me. Rule book. Let's take a look in here. Looks to be fairly well written. Kind of a type. Is a little bit small. A lot more rules than I thought that I'd see in a game like this, but I'll give them a read. I'm pretty sure they're good. Some diagrams in there, that's nice. The infamous sticker sheets and the sticker sheet instructions. A game that actually has an instruction sheet for stickers. Probably very good that they added that. I'm not a big fan of stickering my own stuff, basically because, once again, my big clumsy fingers has trouble doing it. But it's a smaller publishing company and probably just had to be that way. So the stickers, just give you kind of a close-up of these. I don't know, they look cool. Maybe would have been a little bit better if the things had been in color. But, you know, what are you going to do? I'm sure they'll work perfectly fine. And the artwork isn't bad at all. It's actually, you know, really well done. Reminds me of, just staring at it right now, definitely reminds me of cracking open some old monster manuals from D&D from back in the day. So, not a bad thing at all. And the game boards. Let me see if I can get these out of here. All right. These are very flat. So that you don't have to worry about the stuff bouncing off it or falling in the cracks in the middle for a dexterity game, which is good. It looks sturdy, double-sided. The infamous green room that I've heard some people complain about. I mean, really doesn't matter. I kind of like it, actually. It looks kind of neat. I'll have to read more about it, of course, but yeah, I don't think it's a bad thing at all. So, there we go. big pile of components, and I got some sticker ring to do in my future. As soon as I get this stuff set up and play it a few times, I plan on playing it this evening with Pekka, I'll post my review. I'm excited to play it. This is one of those games that I just had to have. So, all right, awesome. Thanks very much, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the review.